Is there like a way up again? I feel like I might have missed something. Because we're kind of at the end of the line right here. I may have to go back to find a way up that I missed, because it looked like there was a path that was continuing. But this seems like kind of a dead end. Unless it wants me to climb over these rocks. I'm pretty sure... Oh, what's this now? It looks like paint. That's creepy. Is that NE? Like northeast? Looks like a backwards northeast. I have no clue what these symbols mean. Just like I have no clue what the narration means. Oh, car tires. Huh. Interesting. Now, I did play this a teeny bit in order to test, because I always have to test to make sure that the game will record all right with Steam. But, in those tests, I learned that going in the water is bad, just kills you. And you just get respawned somewhere else. And I also learned that the narration you get differs from playthrough to playthrough. Although the narration is so vague and disjointed, you can barely tell that it's different. Well, you can tell it's different, but it doesn't really help much to understand what's going on in either case, so... Yeah. There's gotta be a way up back here somewhere that I missed, because I was facing the wrong direction. Ah, there we are. Stairs. Okay, well, at least I checked out what was down here on the beach, so... Now we know. There's, some markings in the sand and some paint on the wall. For whatever reason. These stairs are sure weathered. It's kind of cool. Strange, though. Not sure what these stairs are or why any of this stuff is here. I'm really completely clueless as to what's going on and why. Why are we here? Who are we? What is this place? What are we doing? What's the narrator talking about? Will we ever understand? Keep watching and find out! In most games, you're trying to overcome puzzles or fighting enemies.
Dominus' book had not been taken out from the library since 1974. I decided it would never be missed as I slipped it under my coat and avoided the librarian's gaze on the way out. If the subject matter is obscure, the writer's literary style is even more so. It is not the text of a stable or trustworthy reporter. Perhaps it is fitting that my only companion in these last days should be a stolen book written by a dying man.
Okay, so Donnelly's dead, and this is clearly set sometime after 1974. Alright, and I guess that's kind of, that narration there is kind of a meta-text, well not meta-text exactly, but kind of...
When someone had died or was dying... Was so ill they gave up what little hope they could sacrifice. They cut parallel lines into the cliff, exposing the white chalk beneath. You could see them from the mainland or the fishing boat, and notice and aid, or impose a cordon of protection, and wait a generation until whatever pestilence stalked the cliff path died along with its hosts. My lines are just for this, to keep any would-be rescuers at bay. The infection is not simply of the flesh.
Is that referencing the chalk lines we saw down below? I thought it was paint, but apparently it was chalk. Alright. Well, let me talk about what I was going to say before I move on, or else he's going to start narrating again, and then I'll never catch up with what I was going to say. What I was going to say, it's almost like the narration is admitting that it's by an untrustworthy narrator, and that it's disjointed because it's by a crazed dying man. Maybe that's who we are, then. Maybe we're a sick man, and we are the narrator after all. And this is kind of... The narration we're hearing is in our voice, but being read from some book we're writing along the way, or that we'll write when we get somewhere in the future. So it's kind of a weird mixture of... I don't know. That's my best guess. What are those, like gravestones? No, they're just rocks. Those look like gravestones, though. Kind of strange rocks. Huh. Alright. It's even got some seaweed or moss or something on it. Like the water's come up to this point. Maybe it's just moss. I guess it...
I quote directly. A motley lot with little to recommend them. I have now spent 3 days in their company. That is, I fear, enough for any man not born amongst them. Despite their tedious inclination to quote scripture, they seem to me the most godforsaken of all the inhabitants of the Outer Isles. Indeed, in this case, the very gravity of that term, forsaken by God, seems to find its very apex. It appears to me that Donnelly, too, found those who wander this shoreline to be adrift from any chance of redemption. Did he include himself in that, I wonder?
Who is this Donnelly? The person who wrote the book. That I see that lighthouse right there. And since this is called the lighthouse, I get the sense I'm supposed to walk over there. But the path has been leading me this direction so far. Based mostly on these barbed wire fences. Most games, as I was saying, have interaction of some kind. But so far, for an interactive, air quotes, storytelling game, this hasn't had a lot of interaction. It's more like take a trip over the mountains and around the island while we tell you a story.
I met Paul. I made my own little pilgrimage. My Damascus, a small semi-detached on the outskirts of Wolverhampton. We drank coffee in his kitchen and tried to connect to one another. Although he knew I hadn't come in search of an apology, reason, or retribution, he still spiraled in panic, thrown high and lucid by his own dented bonnet. Responsibility had made him old. Like us, he'd already passed beyond any conceivable boundary of life.
Okay, so, Paul. Clearly we didn't meet him just now, so this must be something that happened before. Ooh, there's a path. Should I go that way or into the cave? Let me finish talking here first and then we'll decide. A bonnet, in UK terms, it would be the hood of the car. So I assume by dented bonnet, it doesn't mean that he's wearing a girl's headdress that has a little ruffle in it. I assume it means that he's got a dent in his car and he's nervous or something. So, I guess there was an accident or something. Maybe the narrator... Maybe he feels guilty because he killed someone the narrator loves, maybe? Possibly.
I find myself increasingly unable to find that point where the hermit ends and Paul and I begin. We are woven into a sodden blanket, stuffed into the bottom of a boat to stop the leak and hold back the ocean. My neck aches from staring up at the aerial. It mirrors the dull throb in my gut where I am sure I've begun to form another stone. In my dreams, it forms into a perfect representation of Lot's wife, head over her shoulder, staring along the motorway at the approaching traffic in a vacuum of fatalistic calm.
Lot's wife. And of course, that's a biblical reference because Lot's wife, when Lot and his family were fleeing Sodom and Gomorrah when they were being destroyed by God, because God's a prick and hates gay people like a prick, Lot's wife looked back and it was turned into a pillar of salt, and Lot's like, "Hey God, what the hell?" And God's like, "Oh well." Look at this. This is clearly a neuron, an axiom. Axiom? Whatever. It's a neuron. From the brain. And this is another chemical symbol, another hydrocarbon of some kind. Not sure what those lines on the end represent. These glowy things in the cave sure look gorgeous, though. I love the design of this cave here. What do we got here? Looks like an octopus or something. Or an amoeba. So like another kind of cell of some kind. And this, I have no clue either. Looks like upside down roots or something. Maybe a tree. Not sure what the connection is. But everything there has kind of a root-like system to it. Is it trying to make some kind of visual metaphor? Perhaps? Well, at least we checked out the cave. Now we know to go up the path. Alright. So apparently, I'm assuming that this Paul guy killed the narrator's wife in a car accident. It seems kind of a strange metaphor to call the dead wife Lot's wife, because did she like turn back and turn into salt or something? Was she looking for something behind herself when they got hit by the car and it snapped her neck? Unless she was looking back or something, or looking at something she shouldn't, it seems just a strange metaphor. I'm still on the path, right? Yeah, I seem to be. So I am going towards that. I just had to come all the way down and around and now all the way back. Oh well. As long as I'm going somewhere. It can be hard to tell exactly where I'm going, since the paths are so worn. I wonder who...
He still maintains he wasn't drunk, but tired. I can't make the judgment or the distinction anymore. I was drunk when I landed here, and tired too. I walked up the cliff path in near darkness, and camped in the bay where the trawler lies beached. It was only at dawn that I saw the bothy, and decided to make my temporary lodgings there. I was expecting just the aerial, and a transmitter stashed in a weatherproof box somewhere on the mount. It had an air of uneasy permanence to it. Like all the other buildings here, erosion seems to have evaded it completely.
Well, that's gorgeous. That narration plus the light there plus this music. Wow, that's moving. Yeah, so clearly his wife did die, and the guy claims that he was tired, not drunk. And clearly, we are not the narrator, because clearly the narrator landed on the beach and saw, I'm not sure what a trolley or whatever it is, but I'm guessing that he meant that beach ship back there that we saw, or something like that. But in any case, he came here at night, so it's clearly not us, because we're here either in the morning or in the late afternoon. Here we've got another... What? We've got another hydrocarbon chain of some kind. We've got a Bible. And a chemistry book. Huh. Alright. I guess I'm not smart enough to understand the connection between the Bible and chemistry. Except for the fact that the Bible BS's as far as chemistry goes, because he doesn't... Whatever, let's not bring my religious opinion into this. Let's just focus on the narrative. Let's do that. Interesting. I'd still love to know why there are chains of hydrocarbons all over the place. What's it saying? Am I too stupid? Are the developers just being too vague for this, in an attempt to be artsy, when in reality they're just being vague? Yea, as I walk through the shadow of the valley of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me, and so on. Huh. Oh!